Hey everyone, and welcome back to another March Madness video. Today I want to talk to you guys about a teaching strategy that has really helped me as a classroom music teacher who this year is currently cart teaching, meaning my entire classroom sits on a four-wheeled cart and I take everything to specific classrooms. So the students don't come to me, I now go to their classrooms, which has presented its own set of challenges, and I've been trying different kinds of management and productivity hacks, experiments with the children to see what works well with them, what keeps them focused and on track. I can tell from their end, doing an entire 8-hour school day in one classroom, kind of being confined and socially distanced in one space, is a little bit taxing on them. I do currently teach K through 8th grade, so kindergarten 5-year-olds to 8th grade 14-year-olds, and I've been trying different things. Today I want to talk about exit and entrance songs as a cart teacher. If you are somebody who has experience with this in or outside of this current pandemic, let me know down below in the comment section. And if you are new here, be sure to click that little red subscription button and the bell to be updated for each and every future video. But without any further ado, here are my thoughts and experiences using entrance and exit songs as a teacher. Number one, I find that it really sets the tone for my students. Like I said before, they are all in one classroom for the entire day, and they have issues, I guess I'm trying to put the right words here, they have issues transitioning. Typically when you go to your specials, specials being PE, STEM, art, music, or library, the children leave their classrooms, and that sets the tone. We're going to a new location. But this year, the only difference is a teacher wheeling her cart into the same room they've been in all day. And to just explain my setup, every classroom in my building has either a projection or a Clever Touch or an Apple Share screen. So I had to train myself on all of those because I go to 30 different rooms. For me, typically, let's say I'm using a Clever Touch, I will type in the code in my school iPad and I'll have something in the beginning, whether it be a church song, a piano video, a recital, even like a school appropriate Tony Awards performance. Something that sets the tone can be like their entrance songs. With the younger kids, they'll want to sing something. And I used to come in and sing, you know, good morning kindergarten, and they'd sing it back. But being on a cart, I need my entrance song to set the tone and take attention off of me onto them for 1 to 2 minutes so I can set up what we're doing. I have to set up and tear down within that 40-minute block of time, and I do only see these kids once a week, so this execution really needs to work to give me the time I need to set everything up. So if I walk into the class, I'll get my screen on theirs, I'll do a little screen share, I'll play a 2 to 3 minute video, and I will set up. The students know that when that song is on, Miss Besor is not answering questions, she will let you know what's going on. I'll talk about this later in the video, but I do actually use Canva and Google Slides to show the kids on a schedule what we are doing. If you guys want a full video on how I make my classroom schedule, I would be happy to make you that. Give this video a thumbs up and write down below in the comments if you wanna see it. But my students know, they're in their seats. If they have out maybe books or reading or iPad, whatever it is, they will know based on my schedule if we need the iPad or if I need clear desks. This past week, we were writing our quarter notes, eighth notes, triplets, and rests. And the kids knew they just needed a pencil because on the screen it said, you know, welcome to music, warm-up song, entrance song, what I need on the desk. So it sets the tone and it gives me that time to set everything in the classroom, because without that, if you're a first year teacher or maybe somebody who's student teaching to enter in the fall, if you don't set that expectation, your setup becomes a talk show. They'll come up to you, they'll wanna hug you, they'll wanna tell you what they had for lunch, they're gonna wanna tell you about their new pet, what they did, who tattled on them last period. So you must set this tone so they know when the teacher comes in, I'm gonna look for my instructions, I know to clear off my desks, and it honestly just helps us, the teachers, set up and tear down efficiently. I also wrote, it helps the students get focused. Again, same room all day. I honestly think having the kids see me get set up and get focused on our class lesson gets them also focused. They probably think, oh, does she have her boom whackers? Does she have her xylophone, her rhythm gallop? What are we trying to do? A lot of times they'll try to guess what we're doing. And Lord help us, if I write Kahoot on the board, they would all try to guess, what's it gonna be? Piano keys, name that note, whatever. They try to take a lot of guesses on that, but it does help keep them focused. A lot of the kids who I teach after a lunch and recess period, we have a little bit more of a challenge because they are already used to having free time. And the last thing they wanna do is get focused back into a lesson. So for them, and they're sixth graders, so they don't want you to know they own a coat and they don't wanna get focused. Just my experience. What I will do for them is at the beginning of the year, I put out like a Google poll and I ask them, what kind of things do you want to see as our entrance song or our warm up or something like that? For them, I would take their suggestions. Obviously, they had to be school appropriate suggestions. I don't need to see the top 10 mistakes of Fortnite in an entrance, you know, video. But we'd listen to the piano guys or the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. And sometimes I'll use exit tickets, which are just tiny little Google assignments that I put in the classroom. They should take the kids no longer than 90 seconds to do, but in focusing, they take about 3 to 4 minutes, but it lets me again set up. And lastly, I wrote, they make your classes more memorable. I've gotten a lot of messages from parents just saying, hey, my kid didn't even know The Sound of Music or Singing in the Rain or that Frozen was actually a Broadway musical and not just a Disney film, because at the end of class, our exit song, sometimes I do a song with them and we'll sing together. Other times I will make my exit song be something I call a Broadway break. I talked about this in a How I'm Saving the Arts YouTube video. Check it out up in the cards. I will tell the kids, you know, you did a great job. Go ahead and clear off your desks. We have a Broadway break. They know they're about to see some kind of live theater. I have a folder in my school YouTube that just has a bunch of school appropriate performances from classic movies. So they watched Good Morning from Singing in the Rain, the title song from Singing in the Rain, the Anything Goes Tony Award performance, a lot of Frozen clips, so they can actually see, here's how they made Olaf in a real life live musical. And even though we're not going to see live theater, I did do a unit with my K through third grade where we talked about performance audience etiquette. And every once in a while, maybe once every 2 to 3 months, we get to watch a staged performance. I usually keep them about 40, 45 minutes, so they just take one class period. But I tell the kids, if we were going to this performance, how would you behave? What would I expect from you? What would you expect from yourself and your classmates? That way when theater does reopen, they've had that unit. They know, don't sing along, unless obviously the actors ask you to, but if you go see Frozen, the Broadway musical, you don't sing along. You sit even though you know the words, you don't take pictures, you don't have conversations with your friends. These are things I originally was just like, everybody knows how to do this. Then I started directing middle school musicals and I learned that was not the case. Whew. So to recap, entrance and exit songs, very helpful tool with management and productivity, not just for you as the teacher, but for your students, especially a CART teacher who has to set up and tear down in their space. It was a lot easier when I had my own classroom and I had my risers and I had, if I had, you know, kindergarten, fourth and seventh grade back to back, I could lay out those things and I wasn't carting them. They came to me and I had that time to set up. But now that the tables are turned and I have to go into their space, these entrance and exit songs are a lifesaver. Again, it does set the tone that it is now time for music class. It helps get the kids focused on what they're about to learn, and it just makes your class more memorable. My other tip is if you are going to use performance clips, ask them at the end of class what they thought, what they liked, what they thought could be done different or better. Notice how I'm not including what I didn't like. I am trying to teach my young kids that opinions are okay. It's okay to have your own opinions and we can respect ours and other people's. And just having a little bit of a conversation about what we watch. So it's not just watch this so I can clean up and get out of your classroom. It is, today we're gonna be watching Do Re Mi from The Sound of Music. And the kids would recognize, oh, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, So, La, Ti matches C, D, E, F, G, A, B on the piano. And we would make those connections. And my third graders aren't singing solfege yet because I'm trying to figure out how to do that as a CART teacher. If you have any advice, let me know down below. They can sing Do, Re, Mi just fine, but in terms of not having a piano, keyboard, cart teaching solfege has been a little bit of a challenge, but that's a whole other video for a different day. But you guys, that is it. Those are my thoughts and opinions on entrance and exit songs. If you are somebody who has been cart teaching well before this pandemic, let me know what tips, strategies, and techniques or classroom management tips work well for you. I would love to hear them. Of course, give this video a huge thumbs up. Make sure you are subscribed, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.